Welcome to the European House Borer video, an educational video aimed at increasing EHB awareness and managing the threat currently being posed to Australia, primarily Western Australia. European House Borer, also called EHB, is a destructive pest of dry softwood timber, including pine, fir and spruce. Since 2004, EHB infestations in Western Australia have mainly been found in the dead parts of live pine trees and manufactured pine wood materials. However, in early 2009, a significant EHB infestation was found in the structural timbers of a Perth home. The European house borer presents a unique challenge to Australia. If left unchecked, EHB can cause major structural damage to untreated pine wood roof structures and can impact on industry. With this in mind, all Western Australians must play a greater role in ongoing surveillance and control of this serious pest. This video offers strategies to achieve this goal. What is EHB? European house borer is a beetle. Adult EHB beetles are brownish black to black with a slightly flattened appearance and have antennae about half as long as their body. Females are usually the size of a 20-cent piece and males are generally smaller. The beetles may have distinctive white patches on their back. On the top surface of the first body segment, behind the head, are two raised, black, shiny knobs like eyes. The damage is done by EHB larvae that hatch from eggs and tunnel through timber or wood. The eggs are laid in cracks, holes and joints in dead pine trees, dead branches or other dead parts of living pine trees and untreated pine timber. EHB can live in its larval state for up to 12 years, usually without any signs of infestation. In Western Australia, research has shown that the larvae are more likely to live in timber between 2 and 5 years. Once a larva has matured, it will emerge from the timber as a beetle to begin the life cycle again. By reinfesting the same piece of wood, larvae will keep feeding until the point of structural collapse. Infestation to collapse may take 15 to 25 years. This footage was shot following an EHB incursion in Victoria in the 1950s.
After they've hatched, the grubs start chewing into the wood. The transverse body folds aid their movement in the tunnels, and the strong jaws eat out the oval-shaped burrows, or galleries as they're called. These galleries are packed with frass, the undigested powdery material, which is the familiar sign of the presence of a wood borer. The grubs live in these galleries for anything between 3 and 11 years, following the grain of the wood, yet never quite breaking the surface, for they avoid light and will always turn away from it. And so, because it leaves no sign of its presence, the European house borer is probably the most difficult of all wood borers to detect. As it nears the later stages of its development, the grub forms a pupal chamber in one of the galleries. Here it will undergo the transformation from the larval to the adult stage. This gradual transformation from the early pupal stage through the various phases of development to the final adult form takes about 3 weeks. When the adult beetle first emerges, its outer covering is a light creamy colour, but this quickly changes to a dark brown-black, and it then burrows its way out along a previously sealed tunnel. Finally, it leaves the wood through an oval-shaped opening nearly half an inch across. This is the only time the European house borer leaves a mark on the surface of the wood which might betray its presence. But then, of course, it's too late. The damage is done.
History of the EHB incursion. EHB was first discovered in Europe, hence the name European house borer. The pest has since been found in the Middle East, Africa, South America, United States, China, and Asia Minor. There had been an incursion of EHB in Australia's eastern states in the 1950s, but this was eradicated with a concerted government effort over 10 years. It is likely that EHB also made its way into Western Australia at this time through the import of pinewood kit homes. Subsequently, on the 19th of January 2004, a single female EHB was found emerging from a beam in a house in the Perth suburb of Parkerville. As at September 2010, EHB was confirmed at 178 sites across 50 suburbs. This includes 11 plantations and 167 urban sites. EHB infestations have been confined to the Greater Perth metropolitan area, mainly in Nangarra, the Hills and Serpentine areas. There has also been one confirmed find near Albany, which was the result of transportation of EHB-infested pine timber. EHB Response Program. A nationally funded EHB response program commenced in Western Australia in 2004 to determine the extent of the infestation, with the goal of eradicating the pest from the state. An important object of the program was to find every EHB infestation, which involved travelling every road in Western Australia from Geraldton to Esperance each year, to inspect pine trees and dead pine wood. Regular door knock surveys were undertaken in all EHB affected areas, and 200 roofs in Allenbrook were inspected biannually. As part of the eradication program, pine trees were removed in EHB affected areas and manufactured pine wood articles treated or destroyed. By the end of 2010, 137 of the 178 confirmed sites had been cleared of the infested pine wood, and 50 of the 117 surrounding areas were cleared of all host material. The EHB response program reduced EHB populations within affected areas and helped contain the pest to the Perth metropolitan area. Research activities. As part of the EHB response program, research was undertaken into the life cycle, behaviour and identification of EHB. The research team developed the world's first DNA profiling methods for EHB and helped to map the spread of EHB populations around the Perth metropolitan area. Additionally, 6 model research houses were built to test whether EHB can lay eggs and survive in the hot summer conditions of Perth roofs. These trials provided important information on how EHB infestations develop in roof timbers and how to find and treat infestations. In a purpose-built laboratory at South Perth, borer mating and reproduction cycles were also studied. Measurements were taken and samples of infested pine wood were dissected. By knowing where EHB is, how likely it is to spread, and how to detect it, it is hopeful that future management strategies will reduce spread and infestation. Signs of infestation. It can be difficult to detect EHB as larvae can bore inside wood for many years without any external evidence. It is only when the adult beetle emerges from the wood that oval-shaped holes, known as exit holes, are formed. Despite the difficulty of detection, some signs may be seen. Exit holes are oval-shaped, about 5 mm in length, and run in line with the grain. A mixture of fine powdery particles of wood dust and droppings, known as frass, can sometimes be found close to where beetles have emerged. Blister-like swellings under the surface may be evident when boring larvae has eaten through tunnels and packed them with frass. Soft clicking sounds may be heard as the borer eats through the timber. Tunnels or galleries created by the larvae can be seen if the timber has been planed, sawn or split. These tunnels can affect the structural integrity of the wood. Galleries rarely break through the timber surface and are therefore seldom detected. EHB beetles only emerge, fly and mate between September and May, known as the flight season. Remember, EHB does not infest hardwoods and will only infest dead, dry or seasoned pine wood like spruce and firs. EHB spread. Some of the longest distance spread of EHB has been the result of people moving infested pine wood while natural movement has accounted for slower spread. DNA testing shows that original EHB populations may have migrated from the Hills region to Nangarra, maybe from EHB beetles carried on easterly and south-easterly winds in Perth summers. It is also possible that EHB beetles have hitchhiked on vehicles transporting pine wood materials out of or through affected areas. This map shows the spread of EHB throughout the Perth metropolitan areas as at September 2010, and the RMZ areas that were created around infestations to contain further spread of EHB. Detailed high-resolution digital maps of each zone can be viewed on the EHB website. That's www.ehb.wa.gov.au. EHB regulations. Regulations were introduced in 2006 to restrict the movement of pine wood from EHB-affected areas and prevent the human-assisted spread of EHB. In addition to movement restrictions, EHB regulations provide for restrictions on the storage, treatment, and disposal methods for untreated seasoned pine wood located in affected areas, known as restricted movement zones or RMZs. Pine timber exposed in areas where EHB is known to occur must be considered potentially infested, and appropriate precautions must be undertaken to prevent further EHB spread beyond the RMZ. Industries involved in the use of untreated pine products, such as pallets and furniture, must comply with these regulations or face penalties of up to $2,000. Interstate regulations currently being drafted will also affect the movement of pine wood out of Western Australia in the future. Residents and businesses should contact the EHB hotline on 1800 084 881 for further guidance on movement, storage, treatment and disposal arrangements. Timber treatment. From 2000, untreated pine timber became a popular building material, particularly for roof framing, which has put new homes at risk. In response, the WA Building Commission issued an advisory note in 2009, which mandated the use of EHB non-susceptible building materials in EHB-affected areas to prevent future infestation. The note advised that where pine was used as a primary building element in a restricted movement zone, it may be suitable for hazard levels H2 or higher in the case of weather-exposed pine wood. This directive has resulted in an increased demand for treated timber. A WA timber mill incorporating new inline spray technology for H2 treatment has been established to increase the volume and affordability of treated pine wood. Unseasoned pine is processed at the sawmill to produce various sizes of construction timber, with the envelope H2 process incorporated into the plant production line. H3 or higher treated pine wood using LOSP vacuum pressure treatment is also available at facilities in Western Australia. Seasoned pine wood is placed within a vacuum chamber and the process provides for full chemical penetration of the timber. Industry strategies. The challenge in 2011 will be to marry the needs of industry with the need to prevent EHB spread and infestation. Without containment of the pest, industry will have to face increased restrictions regarding building materials and movement of pine wood. With this in mind, strategies have been made available to industry to assist with EHB management. Untreated pine wood in transit must be stored in a suitable building, enclosure, or where impractical, wrapped in plastic. Untreated pine exposed to the environment in an RMZ for 72 hours or more must be considered potentially EHB infested. Waste pine wood must be chipped, burnt, or disposed at local government waste recycle or landfill facilities to prevent further EHB spread. Business should contact call centre hotline on 1800 084 881 for guidance to meet movement restrictions of untreated pine out of RMZs. business located in an area where EHB is known to occur should inform subcontractors and suppliers to use treated pine or other non-susceptible materials. Business can assist with correct handling of untreated pine wood. Businesses are encouraged to develop EHB risk management plans if the use of untreated pine wood forms part of the business activity cycle. EHB and the community. EHB is a threat to Western Australian homes with untreated pine roof structures. While adult beetles generally do not travel until food sources have been exhausted, the locations of EHB infestations have indicated that EHB can fly a distance of 1 to 2 kilometres, which in some suburbs is about the distance between homes and infested trees. In South Africa, about 90% of house roofs adjacent to infested plantations became infested, which resulted in large-scale roof damage. The good news is that in Western Australia, serious damage is unlikely, as most untreated pine wood roof structures are less than 15 years old. Although, to avoid serious infestation in the future, it is imperative that efforts be made to detect EHB. Community strategies. According to a Building Commission of Western Australia's directive in 2009, new homes or renovations undertaken in EHB-affected areas must use materials that are not susceptible to EHB. Homeowners should make sure their builders are complying with this directive and request the use of treated pine wood or other non-susceptible materials. In homes already built with untreated pine timbers, damage can be avoided through early detection with regular inspections by EHB-accredited pest controllers. Training for pest controllers has been updated in 2011 to improve detection capacity and in the future to increase the number of inspectors available. There are also other strategies the community can use to prevent infestation and to stop the spread of EHB. Members of the public should not collect pine wood materials from verge side collections or building sites, or firewood from pine plantations. Any unwanted pine wood should be disposed of through local government waste disposal services or at local government refuse facilities. Ensure that pine wood you want to keep is treated or suitably stored to prevent exposure to EHB. Pine wood exposed to the environment in EHB-affected areas can lead to subsequent infestation of your home. Regularly inspect any pine trees on your property and clear away dead branches. Education and awareness and the future. As the EHB response program transitions from eradication to containment in 2011, there will be an increased risk of EHB spread to non-infested areas. Information on the management tools available will play an important role on reducing this risk. Advice will be made available through exhibitions and displays, road signs, print materials, the EHB website, advertising, briefings, and personal contact with EHB response team members. As a first step, any suspected finds should be reported to the EHB hotline on 1800 084 881. You can also visit the EHB website to learn about EHB and potential signs of infestation and the management strategies available.